Hi, so this video is going to focus on how to convert an improper fraction to a mixed number. So I'm just going to go ahead and jump in and go ahead and get it started here. So the first example we're going to be working on is 59/8, or 59 divided by 8. So one thing that we do need to keep in mind about fractions is, yes, this is 59/8, but that fraction bar there, it actually means division. It means to divide. So when we want to convert an improper fraction to a mixed number, what we're going to want to do is divide our fraction. So we're going to take 59 and we're going to divide it by 8. So I'm just going to rewrite this problem as a division problem. I'm going to rewrite it 59 divided by 8. And you're going to want to do this longhand. Do not take this and type it into a calculator, because if you do so, the calculator is going to spit out a decimal for you, and that is not what we want here. We want it left as a fraction, so we have to do this longhand. So otherwise, so 8 goes into 59 how many times? 8 goes into 59 7 times. 8 times 7 would give us a 56. So we're going to subtract this 56 away, leaving us with a remainder of a 3. And that's where we're going to want to stop with our division. We don't want to continue to go further, because if we do so, that's going to lead us into getting a decimal. So this is how you write your number. So our quotient, this 7 up here, that is going to be our whole number in our mixed number. Our remainder is going to be our numerator, and our denominator is going to stay the same. So our denominator is going to stay an 8. So when we divide, our quotient up here at the top is our whole number, the remainder is our numerator, and our a denominator will stay the same. So my mixed number is going to be 7 3/8. So let's go ahead and practice another one of those. All right, so our next example is going to be 71 divided by 4. So 71/4. So same thing, in order to convert an improper fraction to a mixed number, we divide. So we're going to take 71 and we're going to divide it by the 4. So 4 goes into 7 one time. I'm going to put the 4 down over here so I can subtract. 7 minus 4 is a 3. And let's drop down that 1. Now we're going to be dividing 4 into 31, and 4 goes into 31 7 times, since 7 times 4 gives us a 28. And when we subtract this here, well, let's see, 11 minus 8 gives us a 3, and 2 minus 2 is a 0. So therefore, we have a remainder of a 3 here. So the way that we piece together our mixed number, so our quotient, our whole number quotient up here, that 17, that's going to be our whole number. Our remainder down here is going to be our new numerator. And our denominator was a 4, and it is going to stay a 4. So therefore, our new mixed number is a 17 3/4. So let's go ahead and do one more example here, just to make sure that we do understand exactly what we're doing here. So our third example is going to look like 13/2, or for our purposes, 13 divided by 2. So we're going to go ahead and divide this out, 13 divided by 2. 2 goes into 13 6 times, since 6 times 2 gives us a 12. And when we subtract this, we get a remainder of a 1. So our mixed number, when we piece that together, is going to be a 6 1/2. Because 6 is our whole number quotient up here, we got a 1 as our remainder, so that is our new numerator, and our denominator is going to stay the same, so it's going to stay a 2. So therefore, our new mixed number is 6 1/2.